Big three right now is in basketball. We all know about the Nets. They got Durant, Harden, Kyrie Irving. Yep. Got us to thinking, how about a big three in baseball? I'll do the pitcher edition first. I could have gone with Dodgers, Kershaw, Bueller. Yeah. Okay. But you know what? How about I'll go the new one, San Diego. You got Yu Darvish finished second in the Cy Young voting. Blake Snell won a Cy Young in 2018. And Dinelson Lamet, this guy was fourth in the Cy Young voting this past season. I mean, the fact that they traded for two guys who are top two in Cy Young voting is awfully impressive. Darvish is 34, but had a 2.01 ERA. Snell, as I said, won the Cy Young in 2018. And Lamet, 2.09 ERA in 12 starts. That's a pretty good big three for
me. That's
huge. That's pitcher. How about hitter-wise, big three for you?
This was tough. I mean, it's some good ones.
I thought you might go Braves.
Yeah, I was thinking about
Acuna.
They was right there.
Obviously, yeah.
It was the Dodgers. I went Dodgers.
Yeah.
And it's hard for me because Mookie Betts, Corey Seager, and Cody Bellinger. When Seager, and look, this guy right here is a game changer. Obviously, you give him 12 years and 365. He different, right? That boy different, right? You know, they're built different, right? He different. And Corey Seager just stayed on the field.
Yeah.
And I just want to see more of him. And when you see more of him, it makes all these guys better. But it just speaks to Corey Seager and how many games he's played. When you look at 18, he played 26 games.
Yeah.
That's just not enough. And he's so good. We saw him in the postseason. It was almost like he knew what was coming. It's obviously he was like in the pitcher's meetings of the opposing team going, all right, y'all gonna do that? And I was just, okay, you gonna bring a lefty? Okay, cool.
Yeah.
I know everything you're throwing and you can't get me out. When he's locked in and on the field, he's a difference maker.
Yeah.
That three for me is just, you know, it's pretty special.
Betts and Bellinger, both former MVP. Seager was the NLCS MVP and the World Series MVP. I was thinking about the Nationals because I'm like, well, Soto, Trey Turner, but you don't have a third. Like,
no.
Schwarber's not going to be, he's not in that mix. But Braves is the other one I was thinking about.
Braves solid. Braves is just, it's, you know, Freddie Freeman finally got his due, but I think, you know, over the course of a season, full season, you see Freddie, you know, he do some special things.
Yeah.
And you seeing him consistently do it, you know, as far as not changing much, but just there. And I always look at steady players, what they do. You look at their stance, stay the same. Look at him at first base. You can throw any ball over there. He going to help you and pick you. He going to do the special things, and he going to keep the clubhouse in check. So all those things, you look at, you know, everybody else in that lineup, Ronald Acuña Jr., you can go down the list. But I just look at right now, the big three for me is Betts, Seager, and Bellinger.
I thought about the Yankees, LeMahieu, Judge, Stanton, but health concerns a little bit.
Well, you don't see. That's why I did top right field. I mean, it's coming up, we'll get into it. But you just need more of guys on the field, and I can speak to that because accountability is everything as far as being able to, pick your big three, but numbers to back them up. When you just mention former, MVPs and this and that, these guys. Hit that bill.
You gotta walk the walk.